Brother Wentworth is an explosive mix of sex and drugs and violence, but the latest episode of the gritty series caused international headlines, showing what's been called the most graphic scene to air in the history of Australian television when the freak cut out the tongue of inmate Lucy Gambaro. Now, Sally-Anne Upton plays the unfortunate Juicy Lucy, and she joins us now. Hello!
Hello, everyone. I can now talk.
Half the time, yes.
Tongue gate, they call me.
Well, the episode is so violent that we actually can't show any vision of it because it's just too traumatic, but we do have a couple of photos. What was it like filming such a violent scene?
Well, I first got the heads up from the producers about this going to happen, the trajectory of the character. And the first thing I felt was, I don't do my one-liners anymore.
Yeah. So
I was a bit sad about that. But then I realised it was going to be a moment in television, and me and Pam worked really hard at rehearsing it really well.
Right. Mm.
And we had Fiona Banks as our director, and she was just brilliant. So we went into it with that attitude, and we did it really authentic as we could be.
For people who might not be familiar with the show, why did Juicy Lucy have her tongue cut out?
Well, I think Juicy Lucy is very misunderstood.
Of course you do.
Yeah, I know. She's a shocker. My mum can't even watch the show because it's just too much. But basically, Juicy Lucy is a timer. She really, she's a little bit like a sexual predator. She'll make you laugh and then she'll rape and pillage you, basically.
Oh, okay.
But the thing about Juicy Lucy, she did something terrible to Ferguson in series series four. So Ferguson came back at her in this.
Revenge.
And what a very beautiful revenge she did was just take her tongue out so she can't speak or do what she wants. So it was really, really, it was one of those moments in Ferguson's psyche and something that Juicy just didn't see coming, really.
Because when I saw her, I thought either she's a prison informant or the producers have figured out they can pay actors by the word.
I didn't think of that.
It's all on the contract. Now, just like, of course, the original prison, Wentworth has become a huge hit in the UK, and you've visited the UK since it's aired. Are you like a rock star? Is it like the new Neighbours?
Well, it is over there. It's in 80 countries.
Wow.
It's recreated in 5. Mm. So for us to have a global success, we've got men in the show, as you know, but predominantly women, is just groundbreaking. Mm. So we're very proud of our product. I'm really proud of the crew, as you would know.
Yeah,
the crew are just magical. And you had your Cummins
in
series 3.
Don't
with
you worry. I died at the hands of the freak.
I know.
Yes.
She took me out.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. You know, we've actually had Maggie Kirkpatrick, who played the freak in the original prisoner, on the show, and she loves Wentworth. Yeah. She thinks it is the most brilliant show, which is what a testament.
Well, they don't go for the gore or the graphic of it just for the drama of it. It's usually a storyline that's heading that way, and it's fast paced. All of the fans just didn't see this coming. They thought that I was going for Top Dog, which that moment was hysterical when Vera kept laughing at me, which I wasn't happy about. I really think I could be Top Dog. I think behind that press.
I got to operate the press in one of the...
I'm yet to do that.
Very exciting. Highlight of my life.
Now, Sally-Anne, you mentioned that your mum won't even watch...
My mum won't watch.
But though she does watch Studio 10.
Oh, she...
So can we say a special shout-out to Lillian?
Lillian. Hello, Mum.
We love you, Lillian.
Yeah, she'll love that. She'll be waving at the telly. We can see her back.
Because I imagine what she would be very proud of, though, is that you're a marriage celebrant as well.
Yes,
so you bring
a
lot of joy to people's lives.
I do bring a lot of joy, and I love being a marriage celebrant. The reason why I became one was I was sick of being a wedding singer and seeing really bad celebrants. So I decided to do that, and also I do funerals as well, and that's a sad moment, but I do it in... I just like being there at that moment in people's lives, whether it be joy or sadness, and celebrating.
And but you take your tattoos off, don't you?
I do. You've take... Well, you see, years ago I was on Late Night Catechism as the nun, so my mum said to me when she was watching Wentworth for the first time, I could tell that she was getting a bit upset. And I said, Mum, you don't have to watch it. She goes, if you were a nun in it, I'd watch it. And I said, well, if I was a nun, Mum, I wouldn't be in prison. I just said, don't watch it. It's too graphic. And you know, your loved ones, yeah. They don't like seeing you. That, like, my cousin Katrina has not seen anything. She just can't see me in that light.
Oh. Yeah.
But all my friends came on Tuesday night and I hadn't told them anything. Oh. And they were there and there was a moment where it happened. And my friend Doris, I thought I was going to have to do CPR.
Oh.
Like, yeah. Seriously, I had to make her a cup of tea.
Yeah. Because things are quite technical to shoot, so you don't, it's not as...
It is.
It's sort of scary when you're in it. It's actually often worse to watch it.
Yeah. It is.
And you go, oh, poor me. You're watching yourself get beaten up or something.
Yeah. It's like my sister said, why didn't you want me? Like Colleen. Colleen's living with me. Colleen here. And she turned around to me when everybody left and said, well, you could have given me warning.
Yeah.
And I said, but you're watching the show. Why would I spoil it for you? Mm. You
know? Exactly.
Can I say, what's it like living with Colleen Hewitt? That must have been chaos.
I reckon we should be on Google Box.
Yeah.
I'm on one lounge. I'm on one lounge, she's on the other, and it is hysterical.
Because
she can't remember a thing about the show. And then she asks me 1,000 questions at the beginning, and I say, I don't know. Watch it.
Who's that? Is that the bad guy?
No, it's hysterical.
So is this the last we see of Juicy Lucy, or...?
I can't does say.
Won't get the last word.
I'm tongue-tied at the moment. What? I don't know. Okay. It's one of those things we've just got to wait and see. And
Will your tongue be reattached, maybe?
Well, you can't, love. I'm a nurse. You can't reattach it.
Oh.
The chances of blood loss in a thing.
Well, you're a nurse as well.
Yeah, I'm a RN Division 2 nurse.
Wow,
yeah.
Look at you.
And I researched, and the fact is, there was a guy in Iran that literally got with the wrong crowd, knew too much, and they tortured him by taking out his tongue. And he actually said it was the most painful thing, but you can't scream. So that's why. When Pam does it, I scream and then there's the cut off. And he said it's painful, but you literally can't scream.
My goodness.
So there's a lot
of good news story.
I know.
Morning.
So if you need a marriage celebrant.
If you need a marriage celebrant, I'm your girl. Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Yay.